So one of the things I will have to say is, right now, legislatively, I would ask for 24 hours before I would vote on that particular legislation.
Next question, Sheri, let's start with you. Based on current House rules, do you believe senators have sufficient time to read all bills prior to voting?
Okay, the House rules in the Senate? I'm sorry, I know it's not silly, but according to
that was a typo and I didn't catch it, forgive me. So based on current rules, do you believe senators have sufficient time, or excuse me, representatives have sufficient time to read the bills prior to voting?
No, I don't. Based on the current rules, there is no time limit. I alluded earlier that I would like to have 24 hours to read a bill. I don't think that's too much to ask. As a matter of fact, I pledge to you that if I have not had the opportunity to read and understand the bill, I will have to go ahead and vote no, because I don't want to vote yes and then be surprised by what I see. I never want to have the opportunity for somebody to come up to me and say, wow, did you know that you funded $17 million for a bargain deck for Valdez? So I would rather vote no, even if that changes how we have to do business, even if that changes what happens on Sunny Day, because it's important that I don't pull a Pelosi. I don't want to vote for something and then find out what's in it. 24 hours, I think, is minimal amount of time to read a bill.
All right, let me state a couple things. First of all, there are time limits on what we call conference committee reports. We call them the pink reports, so that when they hit our desk, a person writes the time on that it shows up, and that conference committee must be on your desk, including the budget, for a minimum of 1 hour before they can pull it up. And we do have situations where they'll pull a bill up and someone will state, and so there's a 1 hour time limit. Now, when I first came down there, people told me everybody does a certain amount of research. Some people read every single word of the bill. Some people look up at a particular person to see how they're voting, and then everything in between. I'll give Representative Dudgeons a kudos. He came up with a program 2 years ago, and we have a program in the House that every bill that comes up, and it's limited to the House, yep, it's password protected, and when we do it, it pulls up and it shows every single change that was made in the bill from the last time it was voted on to this time. And so we're moving ahead with technology to use technology in a way that helps us. Because there's so much paper down there, but we're trying to get rid of some of that paper and utilize technology. It is tough. You can ask my wife. I mean, it's during session, it is a 80 to 100 hour a week job. It really is. But if you're committed, and I like to think that, again, to be redundant, I've provided effective conservative leadership down there because I do read the bills. I also know who to trust, who not to trust, which is a big, big factor down there. And you need to learn who's going to tell you the right thing. If I have an education question, I go to Mike Dudgeons. If I have a question on autos, I go to Chairman Rice. So you learn who to go to help you understand and streamline some of those processes. God bless you, and you'll have a great evening. Thank you very much.